Hi everybody, and welcome to episode 21 of Fortress Craft Evolved, season 2, 64-bit mode, survival, and we are doing it on hard mode. Now, I must apologise for the people that have been following the series regularly. I uploaded episode 20 before I uploaded 19, so I do apologise. Hopefully there wasn't too much, "Oh, what's going on, what has he done?" So, okay, that's all now being sorted out. So let's get back to where we were going, and we will get back once I've just got over the heart attack I've had, because the postman just put some Christmas card through the letterbox. Oh, I thought it'd already been. As you can see, we've got those annoying wasps around. I'm not going to do anything about them. They're not attacking, they're not doing anything. We are going to go and have a quick wander around, just to make sure what we're doing, how things are going. Tin is still going okay. You can see that it's degrading now quite quickly. So, you know, we're not doing too bad here. Let's just see if we can uncover a little bit more. We do have more tin that will be downstairs. We were going to say that this is going to be the main pipeline for the energy, because eventually we'll make all this section here into the energy plant. We've got the coal going again. You can see it degraded, you know, over time and stuff like that, and it's doing very well. I still don't think we've upgraded that, no, so we don't really need to have that. We've got copper coming now. We did find a new copper seam, so we did leave the copper seam that was down here. We left that one alone, and we started to concentrate on this copper seam. Now, as you can see, we are working upwards. We've only got a few more bits to do up and down there. And again, this one is going okay. As you can see, this one is full. We're going to take the ore out of here so it goes continuously. And we have also got a lot of work which is further down, but again, this is probably going to be a boring episode because we need to get the copper sorted out, and basically we need to get the copper line running up here directly into this box. You can see how far down that we are, and then we'll have the tin and the copper coming in, so that will then give us time to plan for our manufacturing plants. Okay, so let's see what we've got going on at the moment in there. I don't think we've got anything. We're going to shove in the copper because we don't want it being idle. So we've got 6 bars of tin. We're going to take those, and obviously we are going to make our conveyor belts. Now, I did have a few comments about the quality of the videos. Just a question of why they're not as good as what they should be. Basically, when I render these, they are in high quality mode, but as soon as I upload them to YouTube seems to downgrade them a little bit. Not too sure why they do this, but there's nothing really I can do about it. I do have a high speed internet connection. I'm uploading around about 50 megabytes at a time, so I know it's not the internet connection, but unfortunately there's not much I can do to improve the quality. If I use the high definition setting for the rendering, it takes twice as long. Okay, so there are benefits to doing the longer rendering, but it would mean that if I did longer rendering, it would take twice as long to upload the videos as it does now. At the moment, it takes me about 2 days. Okay, now the reason it takes 2 days, just in case anyone is going to ask, is basically it's an hour recording. It's about 4 hours to process. Okay, so you're looking at 5 hours there, and then it's another hour to 2 hours, even at my internet speed, to upload the video, because depending on the speed and load that YouTube are getting depends how long it takes. Sometimes it takes 30 minutes, sometimes it can take 2 hours. Okay, so it's down to YouTube. So there's really nothing I can do about that, guys, I'm afraid. Okay, but if you do have any more comments or questions or any ideas or anything that I've not covered yet that you would like to see covered, do leave a comment. I do get back to everybody. If I haven't got back to you, then go back to the episodes you left a comment on and you'll probably see a reply. If not, go and send me another comment, okay, because I may have missed it. But hopefully, if we get all of the conveyor belts laid today for the copper, I am then going to believe that we can start having a look at, it's going to be difficult. I think we're going to start having a look. I know it might be a bit early, but we might be having a look at this mass storage thing. But the conveyor belts are the ideal things at the moment, because of collection and power. Now again, not too sure if the devs have done a minor update on this, but it definitely is starting to get darker when it's night time. So if the devs have updated it, well done. It does look a lot darker now. It is a lot more clearer, and I believe that helps quite a lot. If they haven't, then obviously I'm going blind. But you know, it's all well done, how it's doing it and everything like that. So yes, I'm quite happy with how the game is progressing, and it's coming on nice and steady. So you know, all well and done. So we're looking to not do a lot more in the copper situation, because we are actually now looking to, I don't know, dig down a little bit here this way instead and start to put the conveyor belts here. As you can see, we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, maybe 7, and then that will be it. That will be all the conveyor belts for the copper. So put my window back. So yeah, it's quite pleasing to know that we've got things going, things have improved. I may, like I said, bury these later. I don't know how I'm going to do them yet. Again, we're just going to take a few bits and pieces from here. Hypothermia really does come on very quickly in hard mode, but we can soon get rid of that. So there we go for the tin ore. I think we only need this, and then that's all of that done. For those of you that are waiting for the Black Queen to come out, which is the book that I advertised, there is a delay on that due to the fact that the proof has got a few errors in it, and I've got to wait for the second proof to come, so that might not be out in time. But on that note, again, if you like to read, just have a look at it. See what you think. Leave comments again. Okay, so we got the tin smelting. We're actually just going to wait for these 6 tin bars, because there's really not much else that we can go and do at this point in time. Now, in actual fact, there is, because I want to go and have a look now at producing power for us, because we need to think about, hang on, I will get back in a minute. Right, sorry about that guys, that looked like it was the wrong number. So yes, what we were looking at was the getting power to the iron. Okay, so we need to reorganize this, we need to get this going, we need to have a look at getting all that out. So yeah, you know, we've got a lot to do, but you're looking at about 40 maybe 60 hours gameplay here. So it's not got too bad. We've got to get this room sorted out, because we want to see just how good this is going to be. We might even build a power room down there instead. I don't know. Let's go and see what we're doing. They should all be done by now. I think they are. Yes, they are. I've actually got 7, so hopefully I've got enough of the copper. Okay, so here we go. This is where it's going to be very interesting now. Because we are now going to complete this line. As you can see, they've all gone the wrong way around. So you press R on the one that you want to turn. And you can see that they're going up quite nicely. So now that we have got all the copper coming up in one go. You'll see that there's going to be an awful amount of glut. Now, if we can get into a nice thing, you can see that the tin is still coming through, okay, and then the copper is going to follow it. So now that we've managed to get the tin and the copper all running nice and smoothly, you will see if we just watch here for some of the coal to come out as well. As you can see the tin coming. There's a coal. So we just watch it go in. It does take a while for it to go through because it depends which one is doing the accessing first. Make sure we haven't missed it. Don't think we have. Oh, hypothermia again. There you see, there's a coal. So you can see that it does mix it. So you don't have to worry about it altogether, and everything goes quite nicely. Okay, so now what you'll have is a mixture of copper and tin that is now fully automated. And well, what can I say? We've managed to get it done. So now we have to look at, excuse me, how to improve the power supply, okay? This is the biggest issue. We need more power, because if we're going to have power coming off of here, yeah, we need to seriously upgrade the situation. So due to the fact that we've got copper here, sorry, not copper, coal here, okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start to dig out, not all of this one, but I do want to be able to get behind here, okay, because there's quite a big chunk here. Which, if done correctly, we can say, right, this is going to be our main line. Okay, this is going to be left, right, up and down. Okay, so this is our main line. So, what do we do for our cop to get the power? So, where do we have our power station? And I was kind of thinking, and I'm not always very good at thinking, that we could start, I think here, okay, and this is going to be our power room. Now, what I want to try and do is have a look and see what I've got. I've got three of these, okay, so if we've got three of those, let's see, where are they? So let's just space them out. One, two, three. Now this is really, really going to be power hungry, because we are going to get this going nicely. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm not sure if I'm going to have them quite separate, quite so close, just because we've got room, I think it's just going to be worth having these going separately. That won't be too close. Yeah, if we start building the power supply here, because we may move it again later on, not too sure. We're just going to see how it goes. But for now, because what I'm going to need, stop jumping around, is we're going to need definitely the laser there. See, that is going to go to three lasers, okay? Right? So we need three of these. So that does mean we've got a little bit of work to do. I'm not going to do too many at once. I'm going to have a look, see how this is going, because this is going a bit too slow for my liking, okay? I'm not kind of happy with it. So I'm just going to see take this apart. Okay, like I said, I'm not happy with it. We're going to take the macerator off because we're probably seeing how the macerator works. Okay, I'm going to take these off now, because we're going to go and do something different with it, because it's not that nice, neat and tidy. Okay, we will take the coal off as and when we can. Now what we're going to do is we are going to reconfigure this now. We're going to put our laser there, okay? So this is going to be one of the lasers going that way, one of the lasers going that way. Yeah, and I bet you I ain't got enough lasers now. Okay, so now what we're going to do here, I'm going to take this off. Yeah, right, we're going to put the motor, and I can find it here. What I'm going to do is I am going to dig this out, take these up. Thank you. are going to just have a quick rethink of how I want it. I need a hopper here. LED lasers are in the way. We're gonna have a power room here. I am determined to have a power room. So how are we going to get the power room? Here. Obviously we need the hopper there. We need a hopper here. Still not going to be good, is it? Rethink that. Thank you. stuff. That is annoying. Okay, so we can't have this here as of when I want it done. Okay, gonna put the copper there. This is the awkward part when you're trying to plan. Yeah. It goes there like that. That goes there. That goes there. Annoying. Really, really, really annoying. I know it's a bit, you know, why aren't I working and stuff like that, you know, but I will get this working, guys, so don't worry. Right, what we are going to do, we'll have to go here. Okay. The combustible types. We'll go here. Now that's going to be a hopper. Just trying to think. Take all of this up here and then put that like so. I'm still working this out, guys, so give me a few minutes. I will get it sorted. have a brainwave. I don't get them very often. Nearly redesigned it. I'll have to take this up again because I'm not happy with that there. I am happy with that bit there. As you can see, trying to get things better can take a little bit of a while to think about. But if you just put a little bit of thinking into it, it actually does work. Right, here's the start of our power room, okay? So we're just gonna get all this reconfigured. Okay, because we need the hopper, we need the combustible feeder, so we do combustible items. Now when you're feeding off, I suggest you make a 3 gap, okay? This is because if you need to add another line here, okay, you can do it quite easily. If not, you have to move everything back. This is why it's really important that you get the first line done correctly. Once you've got the first line done, then it's not going to be too difficult, okay? Now what we're doing here is we're going to run the power supply, okay? So we're still going to have our main power supply. We need to cut this out. Okay, just too much in a moment. The furnace, I'm gonna leave that for a minute. That's going okay. And so I need to get this off here, this off here. Okay, and we're going to put mining rig laser. Whoops, not the way I want it. Firing. Needs to be blocked off. Not sure how long this episode is, guys. I wasn't watching the clock, so I do apologise if it's too long or too short. But it's just so that you get the gist of the idea. basically what's going to happen is power, coal, going to come around, go through here, come here, hopefully go through the combustibles, okay, and then this is going to generate power, okay. Now we don't have a lot of stuff at the moment. I might have to reconfigure a little bit. This will get powered. Because what we're going to do, we're going to be very, very crafty here. Hopefully it's going to be crafty. We're going to put that there. That goes off there. That goes off there. Okay, so we've still got three bits and pieces going off. Okay, we will have another one going here so we can get the copper and that going. So we'll need to build another one, or go and get one from somewhere, or we'll turn this into the main one. We'll work on it. We're just going to get this coal going again. I'm just going to put some coal in there just to get it going, see how it goes. Okay, that's coal ore. So let's see what happens when we put that in. Okay, so we've got 100 coal there going. Hopefully it's going to be coming all the way down here. It would do if I had it set up correctly. Okay. And of course it's not going to do. Well, it's not going to do all of it. That's going to be annoying. Because now that means it's going to go all the way around there. And we're not going to get what I wanted. So I'm going to put that back there. And I am going to run this. There for the moment. So we'll take that off for the time being, so that all runs there. Empty this out. Empty this out. Another one of those. See, this is a problem with lasers, they don't go down. I am going to get this working before we go. I am determined to get it working. Remember, it was level 49. Yeah, it was level Okay, so I need to go and make one more laser, okay? And then we should be back up and running for the moment. And we still got to work out this tin line. Okay guys, and ladies and gents, I will think about reorganising this, so we have it all working nice. The team, we've got to go. Didn't have that copper there. Is there any coal here? Is this coal place coal over here? Fortunately not. Right, so to fix the problem then, we are going to need to get some bits and pieces done. I'm actually going to cut this one. that's full up. So we can see that's pulsing along. Yeah, okay, so that should mean copper's going to start coming back up. Now then, this tin. Okay, so... I think it's going to reach, but it won't take us long to fix this. We can always adjust it. Thank you. Okay, guys, so what we've got is we've got tin coming from one direction, we've got copper coming from another direction. We've got rid of the coal face at the moment. That's coming in from there. That can go through. Not too fussed about that at the moment. It will come across here. And it will come across down here and here. And we will make some more bits and pieces, okay? Because this is going to be our power room, okay? And this is what we're going to be working on in the next few episodes. Because once we've got our power room, we can start doing power tiller lifts. And we can start really getting on to making sure that the main power line here, yeah, this is going to be the centre hub, it's got enough power, and above that, coming from above, will be our solar, okay, and this is going to be our generator cores. Okay, so we're going to need generator there. And for the moment, I'm going to put a generator there. Okay. And we're going to have power there. So you can see that this at the moment is going to be running off this coal. It's going to be okay. When it stops, it stops. We will have enough bits and pieces to keep carrying on. We will work on this, and we will get the next laser back in here, okay, because that's the one that we need. It's not where I wanted it, but hey, it's working. That and that's what we need for it to be working, okay? So for us to get the coal, we can either have a separate coal seam, which I might have actually as a separate coal seam, and have the power run. I'll think over that over the next day or two, okay? I'm going to end the episode here. I hope you've enjoyed the rearrangement that we've done. It looks a lot more tidier. You can see now that this is a long line. This is going to be a long line. So we can go searching for quite a lot of ores, have it coming in different places. We are going to be going for a lot of rearrangements. But we'll get there. So from myself, HMK, have fun, stay safe, and hope to see you for episode 22, when we fix the bits and pieces that need to be fixed, and hopefully we can start on mass storage in the next few couple of episodes. So have fun, stay safe, bye for now.